This is a production of PBS 39.
Now that the warm weather's hit, you may be one of those folks who has to run and have your double iced latte every day. Well, you know, that adds up financially, so we're going to help you learn how to make them at home and save a little money and have a whole lot of fun. Special guest joins me over in the cooking set right now, Jim Zebert from Sagra Cooking School. We are so glad to have you back, Jim. Appreciate your time.
That's nice to be back.
What are we making today?
Well, today we're going to make frozen hot chocolate.
Frozen hot chocolate. Yes. Rather decadently, as I understand.
A little bit, yes.
Heavy on the decadence. Okay. If people need the whole recipe, they can find it by heading to WLVT.org. So fear not, you don't have to write crazy and get this all down. We have it on our website for you. But where do we start?
Okay. Well, a lot of people ask, how can you have frozen hot chocolate? Well, because one part of it is hot to begin with. We do need to make some hot chocolate. And then we're going to freeze it with ice in a blender with some other milk.
Okay.
All right. So to start, well, we're going to use the Vosges chocolates from Chicago. They make flavored cocoa powders. This one is a Parisian style, which is done with a lot of vanilla and a little bit of caramel in it. That's an excellent cocoa.
Ooh, caramel. I like that.
So simply, we're going to take the cocoa.
Okay.
And we're going to put it in something that can go in the microwave. And we're going to add some cream.
Okay.
And then, Amy, we need a little bit of butter to put it in.
Because, well, you know,
I heard you say decadent.
So that's the way we like it.
We're going to put butter in there. And now this, you would just stir together a little bit in your measuring cup. And then you're going to put it in the microwave just for about a minute, because you just want it to melt together. And this is very French. This is a ganache.
Ganache.
So more decadent.
I love the ganache.
So that's just in the microwave for a minute. And then when it comes out, Amy, what you have is your ganache.
And you could eat it with a spoon if you wanted, but that's the heavy-duty stuff.
Right, and this is the actual hot part of the hot chocolate. So we're going to have to let sit at room temperature just for a little bit, about 15, 20 minutes, because you want it to thicken up.
So we can work on dinner, we can run and get a shower, take care of the kids. You got a little downtime in between this recipe.
Yeah, just about 15 minutes.
Sounds good.
All right, so once you've had your ganache, the next thing we need, which is important, is crushed ice. And the people say, well, you know, I got ice at home and the ice cubes and stuff. No, the best thing to do, Amy, is get yourself a bag of ice, Ziploc it twice, and take a good rolling pin and let the ice know who's in charge.
Jim, you are in charge.
My wife says I'm not. But just, give it some good wax in there. And that's probably good, because I was working on this a little bit before we went.
Okay.
And hopefully I can get it open. And how much ice do you put in? Well, really, it depends on how cold you want your frozen hot chocolate to be.
And what's the serving size? How many will we make with this?
Well, with this recipe, you're going to make two.
Two.
But really, when you count me in that equation?
One and a half?
One, if not. It's a warm-up.
Okay.
So we have our ice in here, and now we want to go ahead and, because this is pretty broken up, if it wasn't, you could go ahead and turn it on and let crush a little bit, but that's good, and we're going to put our cream in there right now. Then we're going to put the lid on. We're going to turn it on for a minute. And that's good. That's plenty of time for that. And now we get to add the decadent.
Oh, my favorite.
Women put it
love
all
chocolate.
In. Oh, it's good for
it. Put it all in.
Yeah, don't skimp. Okay, then we need to put the lid back on. Because I've tried it without the lid, and I can tell you it doesn't work.
Good.
Nope. You ready?
Yes.
And give it a lot of speed. You give it a lot of speed, Amy, because people are always concerned about calories.
Okay.
And what I have found is that when you blend things like this on high speed, the calories tend to stay at the bottom.
Because
the
heaviness
blender.
Separates.
No, I'm only kidding you.
No, I like it. It's a nice thought.
I tell myself that all the time. And then we're just going to pour it out into your glass.
Well, do two.
Do two? Okay.
I hate to drink alone.
Okay. Now, to make this thing special, we have some fresh whipped cream.
Okay.
And we're going to just pipe some right on. And this should support the weight a little bit. See? Right in there. And now, you have two ways to finish this. You have Earth and Vine sells beautiful syrups. And this is a champagne strawberry syrup.
But that's what you have over here.
That's what we have there,
yeah. See, I'm a little intrigued by the Caribbean banana caramel.
Do you want that one?
No, I'm just teasing. You don't have to open it. This is okay. Fine. It looks good, but I'm just assessing all my options here.
And we just float that on there. Well, I'm going to give you one more option. For the adult frozen hot chocolate, tequila.
Okay, well, don't put that in mine.
Okay, well, you have that one.
Okay, you
I'll
can have
this one.
Okay.
And we're just going to float it right on top. And try not to hit too much on the cream because it'll separate the cream a little bit.
Okay.
And then that's it. And then you can drink this with a nice big straw or eat it with a spoon.
Ah, you don't even have a spoon, so I'm going to have to look silly. And
well, you know, I'll have the
bon appetit. Yeah,
bon appetit.
You do the grown-up. I'm just a kid.
Oh.
Jim, I like it.
That's good.
Frozen hot chocolate, a great summer treat. Jim Zebert from Sagra Cooking School in Bethlehem Township. Thanks so much for coming
You're welcome,
and giving us this great recipe. We'll have to test it out all summer long.
Okay, because that was good.